With the introduction of .NET 7, .NET MAUI gained a ton of cool desktop features that you can use for your desktop apps built with .NET MAUI. Let's go check them out. So at the time of recording, .NET 7 has just launched, which also means that .NET MAUI gained a new version, which is .NET MAUI 7, then technically, I guess. And with that version, a lot of features that are specific to the desktop has been introduced. So in this video, we're going to look at how to implement tooltips, context menus, and how to size and position your window on your desktop machine. So let's just hop into Visual Studio and check out what this is all about. Here in Visual Studio 2022, also together with .NET 7, Visual Studio, a new version has launched, 17.4 of Visual Studio 2022. So you can install that and you should be able to update to .NET 7 automatically. Well, .NET 7 comes together with Visual Studio then to update your .NET MAUI apps. I got a little video on that, so go check out the corner of your screen right now and review that if you're not sure how to do it. I created a file new .NET MAUI application, and actually let's just run it straight away on Windows here because I already implemented a little bit of code, and I'm curious to see what this is, if you can spot what it is basically. So my Windows application is going to come up, and you can see that the position for it, I'm actually going to spoil it right now, the position for it is going to be a little bit off the side, right? So I set the X and the Y coordinates of where my window should show up. So you can influence where your window is going to show. So let's see a little bit of how to do that. I'm going to go into the Solution Explorer and in my app.xaml, well, actually the code behind for that, so the app.xaml.cs, I have overridden this create window method in here that you can use to, well, that is being used to create the actual initial window for your .NET MAUI app. So I captured the window that's being created, right? We're going to let it run through creating the window first. And then I'm going to say, hey, I want to have this new width, this new height. So I'm going to set that as well. And I'm going to set the X and Y. X, there's this little trick that you can do to remember it, right? Like X is first down the hall and Y is up the stairs. So if we do X a little bit more, then it should move more to the right. So if I set this to 1000, then we should see like the difference, right? So if I stop running this and run it again, then now we should see our window move to the side. And of course, you can do all kinds of calculations. You can show it, make it show up in like the center of your screen, or do other kinds of things that you want to do here. See, so here we are. Our window has now moved to the right side. So you can influence like the X and Y position here. So let's move it a little bit down to the middle. Let's do something like that. And you can also influence like the width and the height, right? So this has a width of 800 and a height of 600. Now, I set it just like this. You can also set the minimum and the maximum height. So I can set window dot minimum height is, well, let's set it to this one as well. And window dot minimum width, same thing. Let's set it to the width and the height. So it can never be smaller than 800 by 600, right? And that's really cool. So we get this window. It should now be more to the center. But it has this minimum width and height. So I shouldn't be able to resize it, at least not beyond the minimum, right? So I'm going to do the resize here and I can make it bigger, right? But I cannot make it smaller than the size that I set it. So you can influence that as well. Let's go even further. Let's set a maximum. So we have a maximum as well. So let's set the maximum width and the maximum height as well. So max, here we go. And now, because I do together with the min, and if you leave one out, right, so I now set the min and the max, so I shouldn't be able to resize it at all, basically. But you can also do only the max, and you can resize like smaller, but not larger, right? So you can mix and match depending on your needs right here. But if I try to resize now, nothing is going to happen. So you could pin it to that one single size if that's what you want. On top of all this, we also have a new event here. So we have the window dot size changed, which is an event. And with that, you can trigger a little event. You can trigger some code whenever the size has been changed off your window, and you can implement code if that's what you need right there. So you can do all of that. There is a node for, let's keep this in here actually, for the sample code that you're going to find on GitHub. So there is a node for macOS. For macOS, I think some features are not really possible. It's just not possible on macOS. I think like the positioning of the screen. So make sure to check out the documentation for that. But for Windows, this all is here. Now, the other thing, tooltips. Tooltips we can go over very quickly. Let's jump into my mainpage.xaml, and here in my image, let's add a little tooltip to the image, and I can say tooltip properties.txt. It only has one thing, .txt. Tooltips, you know, they're, how hard can it be? It just has a text. This is a nice image. If I save that, run it again, we're going to see that same window. And, you know, a tooltip kind of like works because you, if you hover over the element, it will show up after a short period, a short timeout, right? So whenever I hover here over the image, you can see it comes up with, boom, this is a nice image. And I can do this for all visual elements, right? So I can also copy this and go to this Hello World label and add it here. And I can say, this is not a image, right? So I can do that, save it. And I think with hot reload, it will automatically pick it up. So if I go here, this is not an image, right? So this is, you can do that over all visual elements. And it's like a thing that is very much on desktop. You know, it doesn't even work on mobile because you can't really hover over something with a cursor. But this is very something desktop that helps out, that is known in mostly the Windows world as well, I think, where you can get a little bit more information about the thing that you're hovering over. If you want to have a little bit more interaction here, you can add a context menu. So again, let's take the image here, and I make this not self-closing, because that's not going to work. We want to have something inside of here. So let's do slash image. And what I can do inside of here, I can say fly out base and the context fly out. So the naming is might, you know, it might surprise you a little bit. It's something that you really have to know, but there it is. It's just like this. And here we have a menu fly out. So we're going to create the menu right here. And here you can do a couple of different things. So we can have a menu fly out item. Right, so I can just create an item with a text, and I can say this is a menu item. All right, so now we have a menu item, I think, with XAML hot reload. It should work again. So if I right click on this image, now we have this is a menu item, and you can click it, right? Because we have a command here. So you can do this with MVVM, add a command in here that you want to execute, or you can just use this click handler, and I can create a new event. A event here in the background, we got one, and let's just do a display alert so you know that it actually works here. And let's do hello clicked, I don't know, just have something in here so that you can see it works. I think this doesn't really get picked up. This is a bit too much changes for all the hot reload. So let's just quickly stop and restart my application right here. And whenever it comes up, I can now right click that context menu. And whenever I click it, I can trigger some code and that will show this dialogue, right? So I can trigger actual things here. Here you are. So there's that. And what you can do more, right? You can do a little bit more styling here. So this is just a menu flyout item. We can have a little, let's do another one. Let's just copy this. This one, this is a menu item two, and we can add in here a little menu flyout separator, so we can have a little separator line. And if I do that, you can see here, right click, you can see a little separator. It might be a little bit hard to see on your screen, but you have a little separator, and we have these two menu items, and you can also nest them. So we can add another one in here, and we can have this menu flyout sub item. And with this sub item, again, you can have a little bit of text, right? So you subscribe, maybe there's a channel on YouTube that you want to subscribe to. This is your sign, do it right now. So did you subscribe? And in here we can then add nested flyout items. So we can say menu flyout item, and I can say text is yes, and have that one, and copy another one and say no, boo, right? And if I save that with XAML hot reload, we should see all the options here. So we have, did you subscribe? Yes, no. And this is a menu item and menu item two. So that is how you can work with context menus. Now, the last thing I want to show you here is the menu bar items. To be honest, I'm not perfectly sure if this is only part of .NET 7 or if we added that in .NET 6 already as well, but we have the menu bar items. So here on your context page, or this works on any page, we can have this context page dot menu bar items, right? So we can add that. And inside of that, we can have menu bar item, and we can give this a text as well. So let's make this file, right? File is always a menu item in there. And whenever I save this, we should see a file menu here at the top. So we have this file menu. And we can here start adding these flyout items again. So menu flyout item with text, and we can do, I don't know, file save is always a thing, right? Or Exit is also always a thing that you want to do in application. So now we have this save and exit menu right here, which is kind of like your main menu of your application. And if you would implement this in macOS, then you would have like the top bar, right? In macOS, you have a top bar, kind of like the taskbar in Windows, which also has all the menu items. So it will show up all in there. And you can, again, you know, add clicked events here, add commands in here, and you can trigger all this code. You can nest them again with like the menu sub items right here. So if I take this fly out sub item with the subscribe yes or no, I can just paste that in here in the menu bar items as well. And we should have that sub menu here as well. Yes, no, boo. Again, subscribe to my channel. So that is a quick overview of all the desktop features that you now have available in .NET MAUI. And in the future, there will definitely be more, but this is what you can work with today in .NET 7. With the introduction of .NET MAUI, we've already said like, hey, we're gonna have a renewed love for our desktop platforms, and here it is. We have all these features specific to desktop development, because none of this will work on a mobile device actually, because these concepts are very specific to desktop platforms. But you know, if we want to support both desktop and mobile equally, then this is choices that we have to make. And I think for the desktop story, this definitely makes sense. You can have multi-window as well. If that's something that you want to see or anything more in depth of what I've shown here today, please let me know down in the comments. Thank you so much for watching again one of my videos. Don't forget, all the code for this video and all videos can be found on my GitHub account. Please click the like button under this video so that this video will spread throughout all the YouTubes to more people that can enjoy this wonderful, wonderful content. Thank you so much for doing that. Subscribe to my channel if you haven't done so already. And maybe you want to check out more .NET MAUI content. You can do so right here in this playlist. Check out this recommended video just for you and this button to see if you're actually subscribed. And I'll see you for the next one.